Thank you. Good morning and welcome to Bibb County School District's first virtual summer academic fair. My name is Makiba Davis Rogers, and I am only one part of a team of four amazing individuals who look forward to engaging you, our Bibb County School District families, in opportunities like today. My partners in crime are Tangie Franks, Shamika Gary, and Pamela Richardson. Together, we are the Family Engagement Program, led by Dr. Nancy Forday, Director of Supplemental Services, and Dr. Lori Ward Rogers, Assistant Superintendent of District Effectiveness and Special Programs. Dr. Forday, if you'd like to speak at this time, the floor is yours.
Good morning. I am so happy to be here. We are making history, our first virtual summer academic fair here in Bibb County. I hope that you had the opportunity to look at the pictures from our academic summers from past, and just know that we will continue to serve you and also our students of Bibb County. I want to say thank you to the most amazing and incredible team here in Bibb County. And on behalf of our 2019 National Superintendent, Dr. Curtis L. Jones Jr., welcome and please enjoy your time with us.
Thank you, Dr. Forday. It is truly a pleasure and honor for me to be your MC today. We do hope that you enjoyed the video presentation honoring some of our past summer academic fairs, as Dr. Forday just mentioned. The summer academic fair, usually held face-to-face, is an annual event hosted by the Title I Family Engagement Program as a way to connect families to camps, learning, and community resources for the summer. This year, in spite of COVID-19, we are thrilled to be able to bring you a taste of the fair in a virtual world. This fair is being recorded for later distribution. I'd like to bring your attention to a link to a sign-in sheet / evaluation that has been shared with you in the Q&A. You will find the Q&A located on your screen as a question mark. Anytime you see a red dot on that question mark, a new post or announcement is there. This is where you may also post comments today. Please do not click the link to the sign-in evaluation form until the end of the fair, as it will take you away from the live broadcast. We just wanted to make sure you were aware of the Q&A feature and where links will be posted during this live event. Mission first, people always is our mantra, one reflected in our commitment to engaging the community in educating each student for a 21st century global society. Because we believe in the power of community, partnering with our families is key. Our roadmap to success with every student includes building meaningful relationships and partnerships with our students, parents, and the community. The Summer Academic Fair is one way we help to get students reading on grade level and close the knowing-doing gap between home and school. Our program today includes a little bit of math mania with Dr. Tanya Lofton Coons, a preview of a few camp resources, a summer reading challenge, story time fun with our story guru, Mrs. Janice Habersham, a new resource we are excited to share with you, which is our Bibb County School District Padlet, and what we are all excited about, an opportunity to receive a summer backpack filled with resources, one per household, and while supplies last. So, I hope you're ready. I know we are. Get ready for some summer learning. Meet Dr. Tanya Lofton Coombs. She is a passionate educator with 21 years of experience to include gifted, ESOL, and elementary education. She is a school improvement grant coordinator by position, teacher by heart, and community supporter by choice. I give you the phenomenal, amazing Dr. Tanya L. Coombs. Take it away, Tanya.
Good morning, BCSD family. Thank you for participating in today's virtual academic fair. I'd like to begin our Math Mania session by introducing you to our dear friends, Jada Half and John Forth, two of Bibb County's finest who will share three simple ways in which parents can help their children learn math, play with math, and engage in mathematical thinking. Let's take a look at Jada and John's suggestions. First, Jada Half suggests that using picture problems is a playful way to engage your children in algebraic thinking by finding the value of fruit or French fries. Have your children determine whether the answer to the if-then fruit problem is 11 or 14. Then have your children determine if the answer to this fast food problem is 70 or 25. You know, they say the way to a person's heart is through his or her belly. So John Forth suggests that engaging your children in kitchen math is one of the best ways to improve math, literacy, and science skills. By having your children simply double or halve a recipe, they are working on fractions. Next, both Jada and John suggest pairing your children with a friend to engage in playful competitions, like the one they call Who's Right? While completing an online game, Half and Forth selected the answers that are displayed here. So for the blue problem, Half, as noted by the letter H, selected the number 3. And Forth, as noted by the letter F, chose number 4. Who's right? Explain why. For the elementary problem that we see outlined here in blue, rectangle number 4 is the only one that is divided into 2 equal parts. Jada's choice is divided into 2 parts, but they are not equal. Therefore, John Forth is right. Looking at the middle school problem outlined here in green, when 2/8 is reduced, it equals 1/4. Therefore, these two fractions are the only choices that will be plotted at the same location on the number line. Consequently, Jada Half is right. Lastly, for the high school problem that we see outlined in orange, the square root of 63 is the only option to meet two requirements where 1, the number under the radical before it is simplified is a multiple of 9. So 3 is outside the radical after it is simplified. Secondly, since y is a positive integer, the number under the radical must be at least the 4th multiple of 9 or the number 36. So both Jada and John are right. Notice that Who's Right is a fun way to practice skills and meaningful ways to help your children grow in mathematical thinking, mathematical reasoning, and finally in communication. Thank you so much for spending your time during this mathematical moment with us. Now back to you, Ms. Davis.
Thank you, Dr. Coombs. You never cease to amaze me and your ability to translate math mania to a non-math person like myself makes you a number one in my book. In fact, call me after this is over. At this time, we would like to share a series of short videos recognizing a few summer camp resources you may be interested in exploring. Camp resources include information from our CTAE department, Bread of Ministries Life Ministries, Starbase Robbins, McKinney Vento, Peach State and Health Plan, Legacy Builders Foundation, Middle Georgia Regional Library, Stratford Academy Camp Eagle, Greater Allen Chapel Community, and Watching Our Kids Succeed Summer Camp. You will have access to review all camp information through a resource we will share with you later during the live broadcast. Please enjoy the videos.
Morning, guys. This particular lesson on lesson 3.4, what we're going to do is we're going to be learning a little bit about how to use the inspector tool. Okay, the inspector, switch this inspector tool on and off. Just toggle on this button or click on.
Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white. I can go country, grab and buy. I can go bust, eye for eye. I can lose trust, white run, fizzy pop. Where you they go, go, we they go up. Don't rush, slow touch, brown and white. I can go country, grab and buy. I can go bust, eye for eye. I can lose trust, white run, fizzy pop. Where you they go, go, we they go up. Don't rush.
We hope you enjoyed these presentations and do note that this information will be accessible to you via a resource we will introduce to you later during the fair. And now, I'd like to introduce to some and maybe reintroduce to others, Mrs. Janice Habersham. Mrs. Habersham is a retired educator, media specialist from the Bibb County School District. She serves on the Middle Georgia Regional Library Board, Keep Making Bibb Beautiful Board, Georgia and Bibb Retired Educators Executive Boards, and if you'd like to know a little history about Macon, she can guide you on a tour of downtown. She is a musician and director of music at Alethea Baptist Church, and she is our storyteller extraordinaire, Mrs. Janice J. Habersham.
Hello, my name is Habersham, Habersham, Boo Babersham, Banana Fanna, Boo Babersham, Fee Fi, Moo Mama Sham, Habersham. I'm a storyteller, a motivator, a music maker, and a pound cake baker. And I'm here today to tell you a story. It's a folk tale from the country of Liberia on the continent of Africa. A folktale is a story that doesn't belong to any person. It belongs to a whole group of people. And the story is told over and over again, down from generation to generation. Are you ready, everyone? All right, let's go. The title, Two Ways to Count to 10, a Liberian folktale. Long time ago, when the world was brand new, all the animals lived in harmony together. And the king of all the wild animals was King Leopard. Well, the king was getting old and he was thinking, you know, I'm getting old and I don't have a son. I've got to find an heir to the throne. I know what. I'll call a council of all the wild things. And so it was. And so it was. All the animals came from all around to hear King Leopard speak. And they came far and wide, the bees, the bears, the birds, the elephants, the antelope. They all came. Even a little mosquito came to hear what King Leopard had to say. Well, he said, animals, I'm getting old and I need someone to take my throne. And this is my proposition. Whoever can take my spear and throw it into the air and count to 10 before it hits the ground, you will be heir to the throne. And you will be able to marry my beautiful daughter, Princess Leopard. And the crowd said, ooh. And the crowd said, ah. And the crowd said, ooh. And the crowd said, ah. And as they were oohing, ahhing, guess who walked up? Mighty Elephant. He walked up and said, give me that spear. I am the Mighty Elephant. I will be king, said the elephant. Whoever thinks I'm not, don't worry about it. I got this. I will be king. I will do this thing. And he threw the spear up into the air. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Uh-oh. He didn't count to 10. And the crowd said, and the crowd said, and Mighty Elephant went off into the bush. Well, next, the bullocks came up with his mighty horns, pushed everybody out the way and said, give me that spear. I can do this thing. I will be king. He took the spear and tossed it on top of his head with those mighty horns. He tossed the spear up into the air. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh my, he couldn't count to 10. Oh my, he couldn't count to 10. And he ran off into the bush while the crowd said, hee-hee-hee. While the crowd said, hee-hee-hee. Well, guess who swung into the meeting on the vines? Oh, chimpanzee. You know, he was starting to almost walk on his two legs. Chimpanzee said, listen, I got this. Give me that spear. I'm going to be y'all's king because I can do this thing. Chimpanzee took the spear and tossed it into the air. One, two, three, four, five, six, oops, did I do that? And he ran off. Embarrassment, as the crowd said, oh, we're getting worried. Elephant couldn't do it. Bullocks couldn't do it. Chimpanzee couldn't do it. But then guess who came up next? Roaring all the way, the mighty lion. And you know, of course, in the future, lion will be king of all wild things, but not now. But he thought it was his time. So he came forward. Listen, I got this. I will be king. I can do this thing. I know that I'm going to be king one day, so it might as well be now. So lion took the spear, threw it up in the air. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. He almost made it, but he did not count to 10. And the crowd said, they were getting worried. No one could do this thing. And guess who came along? Antelope. The small antelope. You know, the antelope is cousin to the deer. You remember the song? Oh, give me a home where the buffalo roam and the deer and the antelope play. That's him. He came forward and said, almighty leopard, give me a try. I want to be king. I can do this thing. And the crowd said, why in the world would little antelope think he could outdo elephant, bullocks, monkey? What lion? And antelope said, and King Leopard, you have a beautiful daughter. And when I look at her, my heart starts to beat. And Princess Leopard looked back at antelope and her heart started to beat. King Leopard said, stop laughing, everyone. Give him a try. So he took the spear and the antelope threw the spear up in the air and he said, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. He did it. He did it. He cut it by two. He did it. And the crowd went into an uproar, cheering. Oh my goodness. King Leopard came to Antelope and said, truly you deserve to be king of all wild things because you just didn't use your might. You use your brain. And that is a wise king. And so everybody cheered. And guess what? He married Princess Leopard and Antelope. And Princess Leopard lived happily ever after most of the time. Because you're not happy all the time. But they lived happily ever after most of the time. And that is the end of that. I've got a question for you. What 10 ways can make a better reader? Well, I have the answer right here on my little pen. There's 10 ways to become a better reader. You know what the answer is? Read. That's the answer. In order to become a better reader, you have to read. And we want to invite you to your public library this summer, starting now, for the Summer Reading Challenge. There'll be online program and curbside pickup for books. How about that? You can register for the summer reading program at bibblib.org. Or you can download the app Beanstack. Or you can just call 478 744 1-800-800. Go ahead and register. Start reading and be amazing. Now they've got another exciting program at the public library. And guess what? They're going to have free summer lunch. That's at Sherling Library, Lanford Library, and Washington Library on Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays from 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. So go get a book, have lunch, and learn how to become a better reader. Go ahead, read, and be amazing.
Thank you, Mrs. Habersham. We appreciate how you are able to bring words to life and make reading fun. And like Mrs. Habersham said, read, read, read so you can be amazing. There are books available through the library's digital resources, as well as if you go onto your child's class link, you will be able to locate the My On app, and digital books will be available throughout the summer. And fresh off the press, if you're interested in taking AR tests during the summer, your child will be able to take AR tests during the summer. The Summer Reading Challenge that Mrs. Habersham referred to is a partnership between Middle Georgia Regional Library and Bibb County School District. To our families, please share your reading fun with us by joining the Summer Reading Challenge with Middle Georgia Regional Library and Bibb County School District today. Telling stories is always fun. So tell your Summer Reading Challenge story by completing a reading log and sharing it with your homeroom teacher at the beginning of the 2020-2021 school year. You can create your own reading log if you'd like, or download a summer reading log from the Summer Reading Challenge page found on the Bibb County School District's homepage. Now, we'd like to share a new family resource with you, and that is the Bibb County School District Summer Padlet. Right now, I know you are wondering, Pad what? Or what in the world could a Padlet be? Well, think of it as a digital cork board with notes posted on it. This Padlet that we are opening up right now to share with you, because I'd like to show a few features, is organized into five categories. That's the Bibb County School District e-learning resource category, summer camps, family resources, learning resources, and community resources. As you can see, the summer camp information shared earlier can be found here under summer camps. Each category or heading has a bar on the side of it to help you scroll and navigate through the posts underneath the headings. A post can be a video, it could be a link to a document or website, or it could just be text. Let's take a look at a few posts right now. Under the Bibb County School District e-learning, you see a video there for Parent Portal. You can view the video right on the page by clicking on the play button, or you can expand it for you to be able to see it fully. You can also take a look at a flyer such as the one under summer camps. You can view this flyer by clicking on it and opening it up to be able to read clearly. You have the option to be able to print, download, and save on your computer any flyer or document that is located inside of this Padlet. In addition, you might find a link to a website, such as the one found under Family Resources for Sesame Street. You simply click on it and it will open up the web browser for SesameStreet.org. We truly hope that you will enjoy and explore this Padlet and know that this Padlet will be updated throughout the summer as information is added or provided to us throughout the summer. We hope you enjoy it as much as we have. The Family Engagement Program has summer reading backpacks to give away while supplies last. At this time, please locate the Q&A icon on your screen, indicated by a question mark. There should be a red dot next to it, indicated we just shared the link to the Padlet with you. This is where the link to the summer reading backpack registration form will be posted at the end of today's event. The form will ask you for your name, contact information, and your child's student ID or lunch number. Backpacks are for grades K through 12. You will be able to select one backpack per household. Choose the backpack that best fits for your family unit. To ensure safety and to follow guidelines issued by the CDC due to COVID-19, a member of the Title I Family Engagement Team will contact you to verify your selection and provide the location, date, and time of pickup of your backpack. If we run out of backpacks in a grade level, we do have additional reading books entitled 180 Days of Reading for students in grades K through 5 to give away. So please select the grade that is best for your family unit, as there is one book available for each household. Books will only be given out after backpacks run out. The Family Engagement Program has had a lot of fun planning this virtual summer academic fair for you today. We would like to say thank you to each of the organizations that provided camp and community resource information. This information is included in the Bibb County School District Summer Padlet shown earlier. The Padlet, link to this recording, and link to the Summer Backpack Resource Form will be shared through our Bibb County School District's family, Bibb County School District Families Twitter page and Bibb County School District's communications by Friday, June the 12th. Special thanks go to Mrs. Janice Habersham, Dr. Tanya Coons, Vanessa Nguyen, and Bobby Lewis for helping us and supporting us with today's event. If you have any questions regarding information presented today, please call 478-779-2578. Again, that's 478-779-2578. We will be happy to help you in any way we can. At this time, please go to the Q&A indicated by the question mark and complete the sign-in sheet / evaluation located at the top of the post. We'd love to hear your feedback on today's event. It will help us plan for future events. I have so enjoyed being your MC for today, and we are honored to have had you to join us for our first virtual summer academic fair. The link to the summer backpack form has now been posted. Remember, the link to this recording, and the link to the summer backpack resource form will also be shared through our Bibb County School District's Families Twitter page and the Bibb County School District's communications by Friday, June the 12th. We will leave you now with more memories from some of our past fairs. But before we do, we hope you gained some great tips and enjoyed the fair. And from our families to your families, be safe, happy learning, and enjoy this fabulous summer. Thank you.